We believe in a positive spiritual attitude for positive spiritual attainment. PSA, I'm your host, Dr. Michael O. Chapman, pastor of St. Michael Spiritual Church. Glad to be with you on today. This is the day. Glad to be with you on today. It is a great day. So, wherever you're going through, God has an answer. There's a spiritual answer to every situation you have. I'm encouraging you on today. I am. I'm encouraging you on today. If you're driving, slow down. If you are... you want to get there safely, all right? If you, even if it means being a little late, at least you made it safely, okay? Guard yourself, watch your back at all times, okay? Check on the elderly, check on your friends, check on your mom, phone call, whatever you need to do. Check on them today is my prayer for you, all right? And be blessed all over the world. We send you nothing but love wherever you are. God can do it for you, and be embraced. If you're struggling with yourself, I have a word for you. If you're struggling with yourself, and not on the outside, not the outside things, it's the inside things. We want to blame the outside things for our not making it, for our not doing what we need to do, not getting what we need. But it's on the inside that we struggle. And once we understand the struggle, and once we understand who the victor is, then we understand that we can make it on today. So I'm encouraging you on today. Stand. There's no demon that you should be afraid of. There's nothing mightier than God. So why be afraid of that on today? Nothing can destroy you. Nothing can keep you from him. So you need to grasp on. Get in line. Get on the train. Get in line and be positive. Be perfect in his word, in his will today. All right. 708-445-9922. 219-933-9922, 773-288-9922, or call us offline at 708-752-0895. Get your Bibles. Get your Bibles. We're going to Romans on today. We are. We're going to talk about this battle that's going on in between us. And like the letter I read to you, it's powerful because in that the confession is that I know I'm supposed to do something else, but what is it that I'm supposed to do? And when you start thinking like that, you're like, oh, okay, there's something. I feel off track. I feel not comfortable. I feel like I'm in between two worlds. And you're supposed to be only involved in one major world, and that's serving him. That's it, doing the will of the God. And that's the spiritual level, not the physical. That's the spiritual realm. That's where we're supposed to be, okay? So I'm encouraging you on today, all right? We're going to Romans, and I'm reading from the NIV version. This is the pastor's Bible, so may sound a little different from yours, all right? And I think Pastor Bishop McLaurin gave me this Bible, and I'm reading it, and bless them on today. Okay, I'm going to start. Normally I start at I'll start at the first verse, the seventh chapter of Romans. It says, do you not know, brothers, for I am speaking to men who know the law, that the law has authority over a man as long as he lives. For example, by the law, a married woman is bound to her husband as long as he is alive. But if her husband dies, she is released from the law of marriage. So then if she marries another man while her husband is still alive, she is called an adulteress. But if her husband dies, she is released from that law and is not an adulteress, even though she married another man. So The law has its benefits, all right? But that's the physical law. That's not the spiritual law we're talking about, okay? So then we struggle with sin. It's the seventh verse says, what shall we say then if the law is the law of sin? Certainly not. Indeed, I would not have known what sin was except through the law, for I would not have known what coveting really was if the law had not said, do not covet. But sin, seizing the opportunity afforded by the commandment, produced in me every kind of covetous desire. That's flesh. For apart from law, sin is dead. Once I was alive apart from law, but when the commandment came, sin sprang into life and I died. In other words, okay, so the law came, so that's exactly what I did. I did the opposite. I found that the very commandment that was intended to bring life actually brought death. For sin, seizing the opportunity afforded by the commandment, deceived me, and through the commandment put me to death. So then, the law is holy, and the commandment is holy, righteous, and good. The 13th verse says, did that which is good then become death to me? By no means. But in order that sin might be recognized as sin, it produced death in me through what was good, so that through the commandment, sin might become utterly sinful. Once you know, then you're supposed to do better. You're supposed to do better. You have no excuse. Well, I didn't know that was a sin. I didn't know. I didn't feel right, but I didn't think that was a sin. Once you know the law, then if you break it, then that's on you. Don't blame it on somebody else. But then don't go and dive into it head first, knowing that it is sin. The 14th verse says, we know that the law is spiritual, but I am unspiritual, sold as a slave to sin. Now, he's not the only person, because some people, how can I say this without being so blunt? Sex is powerful. It's powerful. Drugs, powerful, powerful. Drugs, powerful. Alcohol, powerful. The adrenaline rush from stealing, from hitting somebody, from taking something that's not yours, very, very powerful and addicting. So that's what that means by you're a slave to it. You are a slave to it. I do not understand what I do. For what I want to do, I do not do. But what I hate to do, I do. Now, that's a confession. And if I do what I do not want to do, I agree that the law is good. As it is no longer I myself who do it, but it is sin living in me. Now, that's when you start making excuses. That's not me. You hear people say, I didn't do it. It's not me. Well, they're talking about the other person inside of them. I didn't do it. I didn't see myself doing it. I know that nothing good lives in me. That is, in my sinful nature, for I have the desire to do what is good, but I cannot carry it out. Now, this is what the lady was saying. She said, I know there's something better in my life. I know it is. I know I'm supposed to be doing something else, but I'm having a hard time carrying it out. And sometimes you use the excuse, I got to take care of my sister. I got to take care of my wife. I got to take care of my man. I got to take care of my husband. I got to take care of my girlfriend and my wife. I got to take care of all of them. I got to take care of all my children. You start using those as excuses to do wrong, to do sin, all right? And you can't carry it out, but you got to die. For what I do is not good. I want to do the evil I do not want to do. This I keep on doing. Now, if I do what I do not want to do, it is no longer I who do it, but it is sin living in me that does it. So A lot of us do that now. He said, that's not me. Actually, that's another side of me. And a lot of people will say, when they get angry, say, you don't want to see that side of me. There's another side of you that's saying, okay, you can do this and get away with this. And there's control over you because you're addicted. You're addicted to whatever it is. You're addicted to stealing. You're addicted to sex. You're addicted to cheating. You're addicted to all that negativity, okay? And he's confessing about it. So the 20th verse, I got an answer for you. The 21st verse says, so I find this law at work. When I want to do good, evil is right there with me. For in my inner being, I delight in God's law. That's the inner being. But I see another law at work in the members of my body, waging war against the law of my mind and making me a prisoner of the law of sin at work within my members. In other words, I am losing this battle. I know I'm fighting every day to do good, but I can't. I'm a slave. All right, what a wretched man I am. That is the first acknowledgement that I'm not right. Things are not right for me. When he says, what a wretched man I am, when you start recognizing that this is out of control, who will rescue me from this body of death? Thanks be to God through Jesus Christ our Lord. And that's your answer. I need a rescue, God. I need a rescue right now. So when she says, I'm confused, I'm doing all these jobs, I'm making all this money, but I'm still not happy. I'm still not satisfied. I got all these material things, and you'll see a lot of people who are rich, but they're not satisfied because they're not doing God's will. There's a war going on. They're smiling on the outside, but inside there's turmoil, okay? And who can rescue him? Who can rescue you? Thanks be to God. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, that's who rescues you. That's who rescues you. You need help. How do I get help? First of all, you got to admit your sins. You got to admit that I got a battle going on inside of me. When I want to do right, I can't. There's a pull. There's an addiction. It's very powerful. Lord, help me get through this. And then when you start saying that, say, I'm not myself. When you say that, then you start dying. That negativity, that old man is dying. And that's what you want. Not a physical death. I mean, the death that I'm not going there anymore. When you want to cheat, here's one. When you want to cheat and you know it's available and you go, you're weak. When you ask for help, Lord, don't let me go. Or don't let me take this weed. Don't let me do this. Don't let me do that. When you start asking God to help you, he will help you. But don't be so weak as I'm going to do it no matter what. Then you're giving in. Then you're giving in to the sin. Okay. So then I myself in my mind, I am a slave to God's law, but in the sinful nature, a slave to the law of sin. I want to be a slave to God's law. Whatever he wants me to do, that's what I want to do. I want to feel better about myself. I want to not look over my shoulder. I want everything to work for my benefit. I want to feel good about what I do and my family. So he's not just going to bless you. He blesses everything you touch. And then when you're on your mission for God, everything works out on your behalf. Everything, not some things, but everything when you give your life over. Then you can look at some things and say, I'm not doing that anymore. When you look at alcohol and say, I don't need to drink. You look at weed, I don't need to smoke. I don't need to take Vicodin. I don't need to take Molly. I don't need to do all of that. Then you overcome some things. You know you're in the spiritual realm. You're on God's program. So I'm lifting you up today. I'm encouraging you to read this chapter. That's the 7th chapter of Romans on today. Read it for yourself and ask God to help you with your sins, whatever they are. And it's like, I'm out of control. Then get in control. You need prayer. You need meditation. You need somebody to talk to. You need to confess. All right. Sometimes you can't do it by yourself. You may need counseling. Okay. But you don't have to tell the world that you do. You just go and get it for yourself. All right. God bless and God keep you and strengthen you. We'll be right back.
You know what? Looking for somebody.